Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. The ladies and gentlemen of the internet and everyone in between, welcome back to our West African playthrough of Crusader Kings 3. We are playing Kraka, the blood mother of Kru of the Unali dynasty. And we're down here on the ocean bank, and a little bit of time has elapsed since the opening episode. This will be episode number 2, and a couple of things have happened. I got enough money to make Kru into a duchy, so we're going to do something with that here in just a moment. Gain control of Baobo with our marshal. So that area is completely under our control now. It's giving us money, giving us levies. We're going to work on debris now. And we're still converting our culture down here. And very important that we get our culture to spread rather quickly. But now, we are a little bit older. We're now 11. At 12 years old, we can start to sway individuals in our court, and our date of birth is the 1st of January 866, and we're 30th of December 877. So birthday's right around the corner for Kraka. Now, a couple of things that happened as well. We did get a cat, pet cat. Its name is Kit Kat, and it's giving us intrigue and learning just because it exists. Very, very good. Our stat line is looking rather good, but we're still not betrothed, and the game doesn't like that. It says, you know, you're not betrothed yet. I was looking through here. I have inheritable traits on, and there's not too much to choose from. I mean, this guy has fecund. Its fertility increases, life expectancy goes up by 5 years. It's a congenital trait. I like that, but he's rather old. He's 40 years old. Not very good. I'd like to find a child. Within 5 years age difference, we have one of our court members, a child of our court, who's 8, and he is comely. Looks like he's going to be decent at diplomacy and decent at stewardship, intrigue, learning. Not very good at martial, which is okay. You really want a husband here who's going to be good at stewardship. We can control more land ourselves directly instead of having to pass it on to other people. Let's go up to 10 years difference. We see this fine young gentleman here. He's 18. He's wandering. He has no land. He has no... I mean, he doesn't live anywhere. He's just wandering the countryside. He is gluttonous, impatient, stubborn. But he does have hail, and he does have thrifty clerk. So his stewardship goes up quite a bit. But stewardship's not that great to begin with, because he has the gluttonous issue. We do have this little gentleman here who's 3, much younger than we are, but he's ill. But he is comely as well. He's also a child of a concubine, not exactly the type of bloodline we're looking for here. So we're going to hold off on that. In addition, a couple of events happened and we had to choose some personality traits. Didn't really like my choices. I had, we got impatient first, which isn't bad. Learning goes down, which is horrible for this character, but it was better than the other options. The second option gave me the choice between shy and gluttonous, and to be quite honest with you, neither of them are any good at all. Actually horrible traits. So I picked, I guess, the lesser of the two evils. Get our hostile scheme resistance up. And our learning is up by one. Diplomacy goes down because she doesn't want to talk to anybody. She's not very good at speaking. Kind of unfortunate. Our first character is not looking that great. But we're going to do what we can with what we've got. Let's go ahead and unpause the game. And you might have heard the music is playing now, softly in the background. A little bit of a difference from the first episode. I forgot to do that. I intended to turn the music on. So we're just kind of playing the waiting game. We can go to war. I'm kind of thinking Gribo, Basa, this group here. They're very weak. Their leader's not very good. We could take them out rather easily, I think. So I think we may do that. Oh my. The puppy. I'm out walking with Gaboto when I hear it. It's a tiny sound. Frail and scared. I look all over, under every stone, around every corner, behind every bush. And finally I find it. A small puppy, all alone, sits between two stones. It's my puppy now. Game pet dog. Diplomacy and prowess go up. Yeah, I think we're going to do that. I don't really care if he has a puppy or not. It's ours now. The cat's name is Kit Kat. I think we're going to name this one Dig Dog. As I pet the dog on the head, she happily wags her tail. What name would suit her? Something historical? Something alluding to her black fur? It is an important decision, and as the dog rolls over to let me pet her stomach, I find myself distracted for a while. But wait, I know. I will name her Dig Dog. What a great name. I agree. I agree. Have a little sip of my drink here. So what's the world looking like? Africa still looks rather the same as it did. Gribo grew. Gribo gained control of Basa. But one thing I want to do is our duchy title, the High Chieftain of Kru. Rename this to something else. How about Ocean? Whoa. Oceanrific. The ocean goers would be the adjective. And we're going to get a nice blue-green ocean collar here. And randomize our thing here a bit. And I found out why I couldn't find most of the icons. I didn't change the thing. You can go here to the emblems. And there's all these different things here. So we're going to go in here and find something that reminds us of the ocean. Okay. We can work with that. Do a blue and black. There we go. Now we should see Oceanrific. Excellent. To the fair Kron Tihina Kakra of Oceanrific. I have been corresponding with your Chancellor Kamui, and I must say that I have come to see you in a new light. Perhaps you're even someone that I one day would be proud to call my friend. Jamantigi Dambatu. Our northern neighbor. We're going to have to go to war with him at some point soon. I'm sure, but for now, I think we take these guys on here. We want Gribo for ourselves. And here we go. Raise everybody up. We have 1,360 troops. And they have 531. Let's get someone in here who is... a jungle? No. Unfortunately. That guy's a reaver. Cute organizer. Movement speed goes up. Looks like they're leaving, which I'm okay with. I mean, they can come over here and do whatever. We'll switch this out to our siege expert, military engineer. Excellent. They're going to probably hop on. Oh, no, they're hopping here. That's fine. It'll take us 10 months. It's going to take them 8, so we actually do have to go back now. Go ahead and get our movement speed guy back on there. What this does is the organizer, movement speed plus 25%, retreat loss is 20% less, desert and dry lands plus 2 advantage, but we're not in the desert or the jungle. We'll get back over there. And right before we hit these guys, we'll switch to this guy. Kit Kat, the gift giver. 2 green eyes follow me as I cross the hallway, and a small meow breaks the silence as Kit Kat pounces from my ankle. He may be young, but he is nonetheless ferocious. As he prances away, I see that he left me a gleaming gift where he had been hiding. Thank you, kind sir. I gained 2 gold. Excellent. So they're trying to get away now. We'll cut them off here. Did I lose my... No. Cautious leader. Let's go ahead and try that. Those were even. Yeah. Not too sure I like that too much. Let's go ahead and bring these guys up again. Pikeman, do you have anything in the jungle? No. About light footmen? Yes. We get some of them as well. We really should win just by sheer numbers here. But they have a 25 combat advantage, but yeah, our numbers are just overwhelming. Our champions are getting maimed and wounded. That's okay. As long as we win. Alright. Go back over here. Oh, it looks like we're... No, I don't want to spend 13 gold to do that. No, thank you. We'll get our movement speed commander back in control here. Task finished. Maybe combatants captured, so... The steward. He's not bad. Our steward is better. Oh, no, wait. Our steward is not better. So I think we recruit this guy. Yeah. I think we recruit this guy and put him in there. Promote culture. Excellent. We need to continue to do that just around the bend here. Takes forever. But it's going to be worth it. All right, you have no choice. I agree. Put you in there. There you go. And we can sway people now. Go ahead and sway him. The reason I wanted to sway is my religious leader was not supporting me. Anyway, I'm out. Dig dog runaway? No. I am out riding my dog. I am out riding. Commas are important. My dog, Dig Dog, beside me when she suddenly runs off into the jungle. My retinue assures me she will come back, but what if she doesn't? Oh my. So, she is patient, right? Oh, she's impatient. So, we're going after the dog. We're going to try to do things the way our character would do them. And that's one of the things. All right, a scheme at court. My spymaster has come with me with grave news. While we do not yet know who, someone is plotting to kill my courtier, Garmuyu. Okay. Am I that worried about him? No. Stop him if you can. Dig Dog, run away. I search for a long time, but not a sign of Dig Dog can be found. As we ride back, the empty space behind my horse makes something inside me ache. No! Dig Dog, why did you leave me? Why, Dig Dog? No. Alright, they're going back again. Whatever, dude. Oh, no, they're not. They're, trying to escape. Oh, they don't know what to do now. I think they started too late. Yeah, we got them now. Let's switch to our best commander. Take these guys down and take their capital building. They still have a massive advantage over us, but we have the sheer numbers. Your hook on Necroma has expired. That's fine. Your glory is widely known. Oh, excellent. Alright, we want to switch to our siege guy now. Right there. Our glory is widely known. We are now distinguished level of fame. Losing prestige every month, but that is because currently training men-at-arms soldiers. 12 champions. I didn't think we had that many champions available. Yeah, we have 6. Yeah. A judgment. My guardian Goto spoke to me about the capital sentence that a lowly thief had been given 2 days ago. Now, this is important. This is another personality trait. He wanted to know what I thought of such a harsh penalty for such a small crime. Gained the trait just. Which is very good. We're not going down the intrigue lifestyle, so that would be fine. Virtuous to us. Cynical. Piety goes down. Intrigue and learning go up considerably. And temperate. That might be the best one. But just is really, really excellent, actually. We're going just. We're going to be a nice character, I guess. We're not going to be a battle-hardened monster or a intrigue, murder everyone around us, stabby girl. We're going to be a nice person. Eschemid Court, my spymaster has come to me with a discovery. She is certain that my champion, Kwaku, is scheming against my courtier, Garmuyu. My commander and champion. Kwaku, what are you doing? He spends prestige, loses opinion of me. Throw him in jail. We'll just let everybody know. We're not going to do anything, though. We'll just let him know. Because he's currently actively leading my army in a siege. Kind of selfish. Not very just. I understand. But, wow. Wait a minute. Holy moly. Okay. We're going to have to, wow. Yeah. The commander matters a lot. We barely got that off, too, in time. Holy crap. Okay. We didn't capture anyone. 21% war score. Very good. All right. They only have 180 soldiers left, but they're all good soldiers. Doesn't look like he has any levies left. Yeah. I mean, it does have levies, 106 of them. All right, took his son hostage. Captured heir 25%. Battles won. Occupying the capital 10%. Ten gold is not worth it. We're just going to take the win and force our demands. Disband the soldiers, and we're going to give this to someone else. Oh, wow. So this one and this one go together. We're going to have to declare on this guy. We can. But who do we want to take control of that? They're not going to have any children. Want someone with some good stewardship. Oh, look at this guy. I was looking for a mate. I found this guy. He's one of our courtiers' kids. He is hideous. Wow. He doesn't look that bad. Poor guy. Alright, Kit Kat secret revealed. I look down to see that my cat, Kit Kat, has dropped a scroll at my feet, sealed in my courtier Ashen's distinct style. Given into curiosity, I skim the text. The deviancy I have committed. Non-believer. Okay. Alright. I wasn't paused there. We need to look at this here. I mean, maybe this guy. Yeah? He has a child. Yeah. I think, Agyemang. There you go, buddy. Enjoy. Yeah, I know I have no player heir. Okay. So, powerful vassal. Oh, I can imprison Kwaku. Scheming against me. Go. So he expects a council position with that lineup of skills, huh? Yeah, I'm just not feeling it. Not feeling it, buddy. But we do want to take this. 1,400 soldiers. Clear war. We want Winyan. And we're going to raise everybody here and head right over here. This should be a fairly easy battle. Fairly easy war. Because now we have our light footmen as well. And an extra 100 archers. Special jungle archers as well. So, very good. We're going to take this guy out. Pretty sure we can catch his army here, hopefully. Looks like it. Yep. Very good. They have the advantage. They're defending, of course. Very good. They got us 25% war score, 95 fame. Didn't lose that many soldiers. I can live with that. Now he's going to come down here. 11 months. Wait a minute. Which is this guy? How long is it? 10. Shave a month off. That's good. And by the time he starts sieging somewhere, I think it'll be fine. Oh, he's coming back. Let's switch to our best commander. Our champion Kwaku wounded Pennon. Our champion Kwaku was wounded by an enemy soldier. Wow. Way to go, buddy. Kwaku. That's our guy who schemed against us. 30% war score. We're 50% now. I think that's going to max out our battle war score. Yeah. So now we just have to hold this territory. Once again, I think I'm going to make the episodes about an hour in length, roundabout. Let me know in the comments below if an hour is, you know, suitable to you. I think that's okay. Shorter, longer, just about right. Let me know, because you can definitely kind of direct traffic here. Okay, enemy combatants captured. Are they anyone important? The war leader was captured, yes. Yeah. You pay 50 for yourself. I'm tempted. But I'm also tempted to just be done with this and move on. There we go. So we're going to give this to someone else. Oh, look at this guy. He's actually a really good steward, so he's getting it. Vengeful, diligent, lustful, thrifty clerk. So he's going in. And I'm going to have two duchies once we create that. Going to take 125 again. We're almost there. So he expects a council position. He can go in as my steward. We're just going to keep shuffling the steward around. Council's not looking too bad right now. Not too bad at all, but definitely let me know what you think about the length of the episode in the comments below. Let me know what you think about what we're doing so far. If you have any suggestions on where we should put our focus next? Oceanrific. What I'm mainly doing is going after the duchies. So I've got this one and this one under our control. I'm going to create this duchy, so we'll have two. And I think when we have three duchies, we can make a kingdom. And Guinea is a kingdom level territory. So we would need Toro, Bassa, Winyan, which we have. We have these two, Bassa, Toro, Kono, and Sapi would be required for that kingdom. Yep. So I think that's what we're going to go for right now. There we go. Now we have a lot of prestige now. So I think we're going to increase the size of these guys to max. We can have another regiment. I think it really only makes sense to have more bush hunters in the jungle, right? Max them out as well. There's no sense in remaining weaker than we could be. We definitely want to be as strong as we possibly can. Okay, peasant rabble targeting you in Lobo. Oh, Kit Kat Charmed Vassal. As I walk outside, I'm greeted by the sight of my steward, Nana Manti. Crouching beside my cat, Kit Kat, tenderly petting his head. "'Tis quite the lovely cat you have, my lady. You're very perceptive. Oh, yes. Excellent. So, our Lobo's under our control. It's got to be because of the culture. So we'll let that go. I mean, if they want to rise up and get crushed, that's up to them. That's totally up to them. Bassa is the next duchy. So these three here. Man, Nuan, and Bassa. I think we'll go with that. These three will be our next targets. And, yeah. Yeah, it looks like there'll be pushovers pretty much. I do want to look and see, because we're 15 now. Next year, we can definitely get married. Evil Blackguard. He is fickle, sadistic, and arrogant. No thanks. No thanks. This guy's almost looking like the one, right? Like he's almost looking like the one. 25-year-old, quick. He is ambitious, paranoid, and deceitful. Gray eminence background. Also a seducer. Do I want a husband that's a seducer that runs around my court seducing everyone? Oh my gosh. Is it this guy? Is he the one? Is he the one? I don't know. I don't know, man. Oh, boy. We're both impatient. He's stubborn. He's gluttonous. I mean, he doesn't have bad personality traits. His hail. He's just a little bit old, but a little bit older. I think we go with this guy. He obviously will accept. Because he's marrying up so much and we're marrying down. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. That's the best prospect that we have, unfortunately. Which is terrible. Alright. Have to learn his language. Well, we may do that. Whoa. Coming of age. With the help of Goboto, I have achieved an understanding of scholarship that far exceeds that of any of my peers. Even though I had a natural inclination towards the subject, my mastery of it is still an achievement. Thinking back on my childhood, I realize I never truly connected with anyone. Even as I saw others playing with friends or whispering about love, I never experienced such things myself. I am certain the coming years will lead to new friends and new opportunities. Akra, you're a woman now. My God, mastermind philosopher. Learning plus 8. Learning lifestyle experience plus 40%. What a monster. Yeah, 21 learning. I am very satisfied with that. Okay. We're definitely going down the learning lifestyle. I think. Culture of fascination progress 35%. That's pretty much going to guarantee it right there. Cultural acceptance gain 20%. Learning per level of devotion plus 2. Yeah, scholar is, that's the one. Development growth as well. Really, really good. Okay. Excellent. Now we have a husband now. We have no available spouse. Why? Oh, we're still betrothed. All right, let's go. Get in here. Get in here, Yakpazua. Okay, manage domain so we can control one additional spot now ourselves. Excellent. Go ahead and learn his language. Oh, we don't need to sway that guy anymore. He already likes us. Right. Spy masters come to me with grave news. We don't yet know who. Someone is planning to kill my courtier, Toimu. Are we that bothered by that? I mean, we should definitely try to stop that from happening, but I don't know. You can go ahead and assist us until we need that extra spot in our holdings. Right now, we don't. Janjay. She looks mad. Holy moly. Covetous antagonist. Wow. He's not a nice person. Okay. Now, we are losing prestige every month now. And I think it's because I just have too many soldiers. So, let's go over here. Let's start with Nuon. Hello? Deadly encounter. I am visiting one of the small rivers close to Chiefdom of Kru. As I am about to quench my thirst, a local woman resolutely positions herself between me and the river. The nerve! Just as I am about to order her removed, she speaks up. There's a crocodile in the water, milady. She was protecting me? Oh. For 15 gold? I could use a woman such as yourself. I really could. She's good at a lot of things. Crocodile? Pff, I saw no crocodile. Well, thank you. Now off you go. And we're going to recruit her. We're going to recruit her to court. And I forgot to raise my army. Let's do that. And she was good at a lot of things. Her. And, oh, our court tutor. We don't have a court tutor. That. Role growth based on aptitude. Champion. I'm not a very good fighter. Hold off on that for now. Yeah, we're absolutely going to smash these guys, which was expected. They didn't have much of an army, and we definitely do. We have too much army, in fact. I went a little overboard with my recruitments. Enemy combatant captured. The Marshal. Ooh. Hello. I'm gonna hang on to you, buddy. You're not gonna get out. All right. Yeah, our bush hunters are doing all the work. Deft diplomacy. My chancellor, Kamui, this guy, has worked hard to convince our neighboring realms and vassals that the peace treaty I entered with Nani Lami of Basa, is flawed, illegitimate, and unfair to me. I am once again free to declare war upon him as I please. Incredible work. Yeah, that'll speed things along nicely. Oh my, he's only got 31 soldiers now. One champion, 30 archers. Well, I'm sorry to say, but this war is over. I'm actually not sorry to say, as if I was speaking with him. With Nana Gardia. This war appears to be over, sir. Thank you for your time. He's going to try. I'll give him that. He has 51 now. I'll give him that. He's going to try. Yeah, his army got wiped. Could have saved those lives. Just let him walk away from the situation. No. Acquaintance taken prisoner. The way of Nazi. He's over here, so he's in prison now. I bet they're going to lose their war. Alright. Siege 1. Force demands. Excellent. This is a whole new duchy, so we're going to get somebody totally new for here. But for right now, we're just going to do that and not take any penalties. So we're going to go here. Clear war. Basa. Raise everybody here and go to work. I don't even think they can come out because they're getting raided currently. Oh, a child is growing in my womb. My husband, Yakpazua, will be proud. Good. Gave the title pregnant, or trait pregnant. Excellent. Oh no, they did have a place to raise an army, looks like. Okay. It looks like the raiders are going to beat his ass before he even gets there. Which is kind of... Oh no. They, okay. The raiders weren't interested or what? That was weird. But, I think we wiped them. Guido has won against Ati, the chiefdom of Ati. Oh. Okay. Some big play moves going on here. 4 months left. Low county control, a new one. I know. That's, county control is going to be a problem for a while, buddy. My court tutor, Necroma, has been aiding me day and night in my efforts to learn Manding. Her dedication to the art of teaching is inspirational. There's not a day where I'm not brought a Manding letter to read, a learned male woman to converse with, or an extraordinary mnemonic rhyme. Truly, I would not be this far along without Necroma's help. Necroma, you deserve a reward. 5 gold. Yeah, why not? Oh, you don't have a husband. Let's fix that for you. Guy is very attractive. That's about all he has going for him, but let's bring him in. There you go. Get a very attractive husband. and 5 gold. Excellent. All right. We're almost done in debris, getting control. Honestly, I'm gonna focus on my area here. This is pretty much gonna be my home area, I think, for the long term. And all these other areas we're gonna divvy out to other people. He's coming back. Captured Pave, the Marshal. He is really good at strategy, but really horrible at fighting. And he's a jungle expert. I actually kind of need this guy. Oh, yeah. I'm going to recruit this guy. Because in the jungle, he is very powerful. And as you can see, we are in the jungle. Everywhere. So, kind of important to have that kind of person. We are bleeding prestige, though. We're going to have to get rid of some men-at-arms groups, unfortunately, it looks like. Alright, Siege 1. Let's enforce those demands, disband everybody. And create the Duchy of Bassa, but more importantly, my son and heir. Now, we want a daughter, ideally. I've talked to countless mothers and midwives, taking their advice to heart. Yet when my time arrived, I realized that no amount of preparation could ever be enough. The pains were all-consuming, and I feared for my life, but I made it through, and now I have a perfect little son. One day, child, you will carry on my legacy. What name would befit such a mighty lord? Oh, my. He is very good. Robust, intelligent, handsome. He is going to be known as Pretty Boy. Pretty Boy Blue. May he grow up to be strong and wise. Pretty Boy Blue. There you go. Oh, let's educate the child. We're not going to educate him myself. We're going to have Necroma do it. Our tutor. If we have any daughters, we will educate them ourselves. All right. So now, Chieftain of Man. And I can't because we just took Winion off of him recently. Think about who's going to get this stuff. Oh, and now we're gaining prestige again. Okay. All right, our first learning lifestyle perk. I think scientific is going to be it. Cultural fascination progress, 35%. And pedagogy next, because our wards get additional skills and can become our friends, which is going to be our daughters. That's what we want. First, we want cultural fascinations. We're not in charge of this, unfortunately. But soon, hopefully, we will be. All right, a most miraculous fish. A local fisherwoman from Debris. Van Lohny, maybe, has come before me, claiming to be able to cook an enchanted supper. Supposedly, she catches dream fish from a secret spot and performs strange rituals upon them. She then serves their heads with each fish, inspiring ecstatic visions for days after consumption. The fisherwoman wrings her hands as she looks at me, eyes alight with greed and fear. So, she gets probably puffer fish, and they send you into a hallucinogenic. 84%, we gain the trait Herbalist, increase my learning by 5, and I get the secret Witch. I mean, I don't even need to see anything else. That's the winner right there. possible outcomes for Prepare It For Me. 40% uplifting visions of the afterlife, or 60% horrifying visions of the afterlife. Okay. And burn her at the stake. And remove her. But I must learn this. I gain herbalist. Increase learning by 5, and I am now a witch. Okay. Get you a nice husband. Now all my daughters will become witches as well. All right. After lots of hard work, I finally learned the Manding language. Endless hours practicing accentuation, sleepless nights mimicking inflection, countless lessons mastering intonation. It was all worth it in the end. During my efforts, I looked to emulate Yakpazua's accent. I'm sure that he would be impressed with my results. And of course, Mel peasants now respect me a great deal more. Feel accomplished. Or send him a letter. But I gain 100 stress because I am shy. Yeah, we're not doing that. Excellent. Now, back to business. Who is going to control these areas? Someone who's going to have children. It's not them. I can give it to my son. Probably not the best plan. What about this guy? Pinon. He's a forest fighter, tough soldier, brave, sadistic, and trusting. Sadistic and trusting, huh? He's 19. Oh boy. Anybody here good? Some of all skills. Let's see. I think Pinon is a decent choice here. We give him both of these. Yeah. There you go. Okay, and he's going to want a position. And he's not going to get one. So he's going to have to be mad about it. And we can create the duchy now, but we still need this. For 9 years, wow. Okay. Maybe we just continue down the coast here. To Gola. Yeah, they've been decimated by something. Or we move east or north into Kong or Adiukru. Or into Boroldu. Kong is these and this. 79 soldiers there. 51 there. 2,000 there. Okay. Well, once again, let me know down in the comments what you think we should do next. Should we move eastward and try to work on this duchy here? Move north into Kong? Or continue down the coast westward into Kono, Sapi? This is the kingdom, actually, so I think that would be the best plan. Yeah, that's a kingdom title, but we would need this as well to create Guinea. Let me know down below in the comments what you think, and I certainly appreciate you spending your most valuable time with me here on the channel, playing some gorgeous Crusader Kings 3. And, yeah. If you liked what you saw, you want to see more, please hit the like button. Let me know in that way. It also helps the channel get more exposure, and it's absolutely free for you to do. Doesn't take but a second. If you like this sort of content in general, consider subscribing, and we'll see you next time around with episode number 3 of Crusader Kings 3.